One of the first lines of defense is your network security. So we're going to spend some time talking about the different options and how networking works for Azure SQL Database and Azure SQL Managed Instance. What you're seeing here is something that might be a typical scenario where you have a virtual machine in, say, one virtual network. Each of those dotted lines represents a virtual network. So this would be US East on the right. You might have another virtual network with other things like Azure VMs in it in US East, but in a different virtual network, and that's on your top left. And in the bottom left, you might have, you know, another virtual machine or an application or another service running in West US in its own virtual network. Additionally, you might try to connect from on-prem, and ultimately you're trying to connect to the database on the right, which doesn't technically sit in a virtual network. And right now we're just talking about Azure SQL Database. Now there are a few options, four main options for setting up connectivity from a network security standpoint. The first is allowing access to Azure services. This is kind of the easiest, and what this is going to do is just by default allow any Azure service. So whether it's in your subscription, another subscription, you know, another person subscription outside of your organization, or just a different service in Azure, if they have the credentials to log in, they'll be able to. So that's kind of the first way. And as you might guess, this is probably of all the ways the least secure because you're opening up your database for other opportunities for people to try to connect to it. Now, the second thing you can do is you can apply firewall rules. So what this is going to do is you see we've kind of allowed all the same things, except we can also now enable on-premises, which is something you couldn't enable with just allowing Azure service access to services. Now, one other thing you'll note here is that I'm going to have to create a firewall rule for every single service that I want to be able to connect to it. So if I have applications and virtual machines with dynamic IP, this is going to pose somewhat of a challenge. In addition to that, when I connect to my SQL database, I'm coming through the public IP address of, in this case, VMs, but it could be, you know, applications or other services as well. And if what you see on the right is how you're going to be able to view the DNS hierarchy, you're going to be able to see, you know, the region, sometimes the control ring, and an IP address. So kind of the next level of security that you can do, which also helps from a management perspective, is virtual network rules. Now, a few things that you'll notice have changed here. I'm no longer connecting directly from a service to a database. And the reason is I've given a virtual network rule to this main virtual network in East US on the right, and basically said anything in this virtual network can connect to that logical database server. So that's going to allow my Azure virtual machine that's in there. And it's also going to allow it to connect from the private IP address of the virtual machine. So this is a subtle change, but this means that, you know, we're one step closer to getting a fully private connection to the database server. Now, I've only added a virtual network rule in this case to that single virtual network in East US. However, I can use other virtual network tools, which are commonly known, like virtual network peering, VNet to VNet, VPN or ExpressRoute from on-prem, and VNet gateways to basically connect these virtual networks together. Now, we don't want you to get bogged down on these types of details. Really, the thing to see is that by adding access to virtual network, I can add access to all of the things in the virtual network, as well as take into account things like dynamic IP addresses. This can make managing easier, and again, it's slightly more secure because we're going through the private endpoint of these various services. Now, at the end of the day, over on the right, you still see the public DNS hierarchy. So anyone can run an NS lookup and kind of find out more information about your database and try to connect to it. So the most recent thing that we've done, and this went GA earlier in 2020, is add this thing called private link. And so what that allows us to do is actually deploy a private endpoint into a virtual network. So in this case, you see I've deployed a private endpoint into that main virtual network in East US we've been using. And this is going to allow me to connect directly to that logical server, but it's the only way that I'm going to be able to connect to that logical server. So this means that for anything to be able to access that logical database server, they're going to need access to this virtual network. So from a configuration standpoint, it doesn't require much more than virtual network rules, but it does give you this added layer of security because now there's only a private endpoint for your logical database. So even if you try to hit the public DNS hierarchy, you're only going to get private type of endpoints, which aren't going to help you connect to the database. So that's kind of a high-level overview of the various options that you have in Azure SQL Database. Now, when we think about Azure SQL Managed Instance, it's very similar. But instead of having this idea of a private endpoint or private link, from the beginning, when you deploy Managed Instance, you're going to deploy one or multiple Managed Instances into its own subnet. So a subnet is basically a grouping of items within a virtual network. So you're able to deploy your MIs into the subnet and access them right off the bat through a private endpoint. So there are some options for Azure SQL Database. For Azure SQL Managed Instance, this is kind of required to get started.
You know, as you've seen, the architecture, how you can connect and set up networking for Azure SQL Database and Managed Instance, let me break down possible steps you can take for you to make your choices on how to set up and configure this network security. First of all, for Azure SQL Database, as Anna just described, private link is your most secure option. So we recommend that to be your first choice to set up network security for Azure SQL Database. There could be reasons why that's not possible. So it's not, even though allow access to Azure services is an easy way, it is a very least secure way. So we recommend turning that off. And then configure a specific set of firewall rules and or virtual network rules to allow your different resources, whether that be inside Azure or that be on-prem, connecting to your Azure database. Now for Azure SQL Managed Instance, as Anna described, there already is a concept of virtual network connectivity. But what we recommend to do, even though you could do it during deployment, is set up your virtual network configuration and subnets before you deploy Azure SQL Managed Instance, because you're probably defining the resources in those VNets are going to want access to your Azure SQL Managed Instance. Now, we realize this can seem complex, especially if you're a SQL Server person that's not spent a lot of time in security. So we want you to follow your standard networking practices and talk to networking people in your organization about how is there might the most secure way and the best way to get your applications and your tools connected to Azure SQL Database and Managed Instance. You know, we've seen some options. Anna has done a very good job visually showing how things interact for network security, whether that's using private link, firewall rules, or virtual networks, both with database and managed instance. And again, we recommend that you talk to network experts in your organization or look at these various options to get the most secure you need balanced with the way to get up and running and connecting to Azure SQL Database or Managed Instance. Look forward to seeing you in our next video.